Hello everyone, on this episode of the Jaka in LA, we'll be hiking at the narrow on Virgin River in Zion National Park and also hiking at the Navajo Loop Trail in Bryce Canyon. These two hiking spots are very popular, fun and unique. So enjoy this video till the end and thank you for watching.
Zion National Park in Utah covers an area of 148,000 acres, or equivalent to 225 square miles. From the parking lot, we take shuttle bus to Sinawava Temple, which is about 20 minutes ride one way. Sinawava Temple is the starting point for the narrow river hike.
Okay. We are here at the Temple Sinawava on the way to the narrow doing the river hike. Junita and Christina, and here's more member of the team, Scott, and then Pipao and Pipai, and then Wiwi. Okay, here we are going to the narrow.
From the Temple of Sinawava bus stop, we hiked about 1 mile down to Virgin River. The narrow is the quintessential slot canyon hike that hike lovers must try.
This is part of the walk toward the narrow, about 1 mile walk from the parking area. So, we'll update you later.
We hike during the winter in October. The temperature is about 50 Fahrenheit or 10 degrees Celsius.
By the window, the autumn leaves.
It is one of the premier hikes in the park. 4 miles. You hike in the North Fork of the Virgin River.
This way.
Surrounded by sheer rock walls and amazing beauty.
Heaven can wait. This is paradise. Just being here with you.
It is challenging, it is unique, and it is memorable. The hike is challenging because we hike on an uneven, slippery, and rocky river boulders. In the winter time, the water temperature is about 30 to 40 Fahrenheit or 0 to 4 degrees Celsius. The narrow has a number of waterfalls. The first reach is Mystery Falls, which is less than half miles from starting point. The narrow is the narrowest section of the Zion Canyon. It is just 20 to 30 feet across. It is safe to hike when the water level is at 50 cubic feet per second or below. Always check with the visitor center before you hike. If there's even a slightest chance of flash flooding, do not hike the narrow. Proper gear for the hike at the narrow is utmost important, especially during the winter time. Wearing waterproof equipment and quick drying pants are well recommended. There are several stores by the visitor center that rent all this necessary equipment. The bottom-up hike, starting from Temple of Sinawava, can be done as a day trip. The total length of bottom-up hike is about 10 miles round trip. The Narrow was first named and descended in 1872 by an explorer and geologist named Grove Carl Gilbert. The canyon walls close in to form tall narrow canyons. From Zion National Park, we are now going to Bryce Canyon. At Bryce Canyon, we are going to hike at Navajo Loop Trail, which begins and ends at Sunset Point. Total distance, about 1.4 miles or 2.2 kilometers round trip. The highlight of the hike is to see the famous Hoodoos named the Thor Hammer. This is the close look of the famous Thor Hammer. Hoodoo is actually limestones sculpted by snow, rain, wind, and sun over a period of millions of years. This hike is traveling down between narrow walls of colorful limestones with views of towering Douglas fir trees. This is the view from Sunset Point, the amphitheater home to more Hoodoos than any place on Earth. The hike is moderately challenging. It is down over 500 feet into the main valley of the Bryce Canyon. Bryce Canyon National Park is named after the pioneer Ebenezer Bryce, who came to this area in 1875. We are now at Bryce Point, and it is early October, and due to the high elevation of Bryce Canyon, the snow came early. Bryce Point is one of the most scenic vistas of the full amphitheater and all its wonders, which amaze the visitors. This place is famous for its extraordinary sunrises. And at this place, we can see the unique geology, the many varieties of rock formations, and different sizes of Hoodoos. And that concludes the video of the Narrow and the Navajo Loop Trail.